tucked away in a lab in Howe Hall.
Students get incredibly excited about this.
Is a printer.
These machines have a huge wow factor.
But not your ordinary HP or Epson.
The technology is absolutely incredible.
Where powder and liquid cartridges replace ink and paper.
This is a UV cured plastic. So it starts out as a liquid. It's exposed to ultraviolet light and hardens into a hard plastic.
Pretty extraordinary evolution of the technology.
As far as students go, this is probably the coolest machine that they come across.
It's absolutely invaluable.
The College of Design, in partnership with the College of Engineering.
Basically, what you can do with these machines is you can print very complex three-dimensional objects.
Share this rapid prototyping 3D printer.
These machines is fairly new technology.
And rapidly changing, yet the process is pretty simple.
You build the model in the SolidWorks.
A computer program.
So you actually have a mathematical surface. Well, then the machine takes that mathematical surface and actually translates it into a solid object. Anywhere from a few minutes to make small parts up to, we've had prints up to close to 70 hours. Very complex prints.
Making the lives of designers, engineers, and college students, among others, much easier.
The beautiful thing about this is that you can actually print parts that are actual parts. Parts that you can pick up, manipulate, snap together, bolt together, use. You could actually use them.
Giving them the ability to visualize and improve and iterate on design, on products as they go. And to spend more time being thoughtful about the design process and ultimately execute better final designs.
The students really benefit because for them, the time constraints are very, very tight for them in their classes. They can take a SolidWorks model, they can actually print it up, and they have their part in their hand within a short period of time. This is something that's very difficult before these machines came to actually do.
The creations and possibilities are endless.
This is a wrench that you print. And basically, this wrench was printed in one piece. So the moving part in here was printed. It wasn't assembled afterwards. So we've done airfoils, cars, trucks. We've done, for research, we've done scale models of sports lighting to put in the wind tunnel for testing. We've done, like I said, the wind turbine blades.
If you can dream it.
All kinds of things. Very, very strange, bizarre things have been built in here.
I can imagine this being completely game-changing for design visualization, allowing you to really flex your design muscle throughout the design process and not pause or stop prematurely because you started to make a model.
Chances are you can likely print it.
The biggest thing is that I've found is convincing students that the machine doesn't care how complex it is. If you can get it drawn on SolidWorks, you can print it on the machine.
Making this unbelievable piece of technology.
It's incredibly important. I mean, you wouldn't be a credible design program without one.
A great asset to Iowa State University.
It's part of our mission to provide students with, state-of-the-art technology, things that they can expect to use once they get into the industry.